Beloved, many people are getting ahead in life, but they're not getting along. What's the use of getting ahead if you're not getting along? I recall many years ago, my father, Dharmacharya Panakrishna, using the family picture of Shivji as a teaching aid to help devotees understand the idea of togetherness, how to coexist peacefully around the family sitting calmly together. He pointed to the several remarkable animals. In today's plural society, he smiled and said, we need to learn to discipline the different and potentially destructive animal instincts. The picture invites us to throw aside lower instinct, the disposition to attack those who appear different. Yes, beloved children, observe how animals that are natural enemies of one another find peace, harmony and bliss in the presence of the divine. The powerful bull of Shivji, the ferocious lion of Parvati Ma, they sit peacefully side by side with one another in readiness to serve them as vehicles. The peacock of Kartikeya, the snake of Shivji, the mouse of Ganeshji and the snake also give up all inherent natural animosities towards one another. They come together, they coexist peacefully to serve Bhagavan. The picture of the Shivji family serves to inspire us to meditate, learn and understand ourselves and about one another and to work in love, unity and harmony under the divine supervision of that Satyam Shivam Sundaram. Community means commune, unity. The picture is teaching inclusion. Nehru once said that the only alternative to coexistence is co-destruction. You know, a learned man once drew a circle on the ground and declared, all who believe like us, in this circle, God loves us alone. Another learned man drew a new circle and professed the same thing. Those outside our circle are condemned. Yet another father came and drew a lovely circle and invited all those who wanted to be people of God to abandon their circle and enter his circle. Soon there were many circles all over the place, folks in each one professing that they were loved by God and the others were hated by God and ought to be avoided and condemned. Well, Shivji came along and with his Trishul, he drew one great sphere like a lingam around all the numerous circles. Children, he smiled and said, all of you are in the embrace of my spherical lingam. Only in ignorance can you now think that you or others are outside of my loving embrace. Beloved, this picture with the ferocious animals coexisting peacefully invites us to think outside of the box, outside of our confining circle, our restricting circle. If we are really in the presence of Bhagavan, if we really have God in our hearts, it won't be reflected in the way we respect, love and live with people of different races and beliefs. We too would be understanding, respecting, accepting and embracing, like the all-embracing Shivlingam that we worship. People teach or train animals to perform amazing tricks. We can learn something from the animals in the picture. Yes, the family picture is a teaching aid. Humanity must reflect divinity in our unity. The world needs this message of peaceful coexistence, not co-destruction. Meditation on Shivji, the truth energy, the love energy, removes a narrow blinkered vision that creates racial and intolerance, enmity. It starts with us as individuals and then as family members, wild animals, our prowling mind, unbridled senses and emotions can bring fear, hate, hurt, destruction. With meditation, in the presence of the divine, the mind, the senses, the emotions become peaceful, blissful, purposeful. This energy of blissfulness and purposefulness spreads to our families, to the community, and then to the whole world family. Do you get the picture? Get the picture. Beloved, sit upright. Relax. Inhale slowly and deeply. And exhale all the aggressiveness and bitterness. Inhale peace. Exhale anger and hate. Inhale love. Exhale. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.